Today went really smoothly for me. I'm quite content with how I did. Of course, there's things I'd like to improve, assuming we get into all-around finals, and looking forward to tomorrow.
So speaking of improvements, what are you planning to work on mainly?
I think execution, I would like to pull that up a little bit more.
Let's talk about your Tokyo experience. You got to go and...
Yes.
Do that again, please, without...
Do that again, without your camera. Wait, how did I do that?
Super cute. So I can see you're carrying part of Tokyo with you.
Always. Always.
What was your highlight during Tokyo Games?
There were so many. One very memorable moment was when I, because you don't allow yourself to feel any emotions while you're competing, and you're trying to stay very in the zone, very focused, and leading up to that too, you don't really allow yourself to feel. And I sat down after my last clubs routine, and clubs is always a bit unique for me, and I did it, and at the time, I was battling really, really bad shin splints for it was about a year now. And so I was in a lot of pain and I couldn't walk. It was honestly a miracle and like blessed by God that I could jump and compete. And so, you know, you ignore that because you have to do a job. And then I sat down after that clubs routine and I just laid down on my couch and I felt like emotions go pew, and I was like, whoa, like in the slow motion movie. And so that was, I think, a very memorable moment.
Wow. You're so eloquent the way you describe it.
Thank you. I love talking.
such an emotional journey. When it comes to artistic gymnastics, Team USA is like rocking the boat. What do you think has to happen for rhythmic gymnastics to also gain the speed and be like up to?
I think it's awareness, honestly. And I think USA Gymnastics has been really pushing equality amongst the different disciplines right now. They've been doing a really good job. They have their new rebranding. They're trying to get athletes on board. So, for example, I also serve as an athlete representative. And we have all the disciplines involved in that. And I think they're listening to our voices and input. And social media, I think, is a great platform to be able to be like, hey, there's this really cool sport. Here's what you didn't know about it. Because from what I've seen in the United States, at least, rhythmic gymnastics has been presented in the media in the past as a joke. You know, they'll take a football player and he'll just run around with a ribbon that's too short, like a, I say headless chicken, don't tell anyone I said that, but you know, it's I think going on an up.
Well, ask those people try to do, I don't know, half of what they're doing. I watch people doing rhythmic gymnastics. It's such a hard sport.
Thank you.
Final question for social media. If you weren't a rhythmic gymnast, what profession would you take and why? Or what would you be?
If I wasn't a rhythmic gymnast? Sports? Well, I'd be a rhythmic gymnast. I think I would probably take up some form of dancing because I love dancing. I teach ballet. I do ballet all the time. So I think I'd go in that avenue. And right now I'm actually a full-time student at Columbia University. So I'm technically in school right now. 2 weeks late. But
what do you study?
I study psychology. So I'd like to pursue something related to that field. So yeah, I think you don't have to... The reason why your question was sort of... took me... a minute to answer is because I think gymnastics is traditionally thought of as like you do gymnastics and then you do something else, or if you are in artistic you have the NCAA in the United States. It's a whole different system, which don't ask me, I don't know, but like for me it's another thing that I can do and another thing that I can use to develop my character and myself. And so just because I'm doing gymnastics doesn't mean that I can't pursue school and a higher level education and build a future in that direction as well. So yeah, I fly between New York and Chicago for training and school, and it's a whole thing. I could talk about forever.
I mean, that's a multi-talented person.
Well, thank you.
Thank you so much.